Good morning. Good morning. It's July 22nd. I'm not going to do a lot of videoing. I just thought I'd show you how deep the cracks are. And it's that way all along. I've never seen that happen before when I've done this maneuver. I'm just going to add a thick layer. Eventually the water will work it down, but I'm just going to cover it. And when I say I've never seen this before, I didn't do this bed too good, but you don't see those deep cracks along the edge there. This was a slip-slidey mess, so I didn't do a lot, but the cracks don't exist here. But they do there. Alright. We may get some rain today, and if we do, that'll help work it down into the cracks. But the wood is deep enough, so I think I'll be fine. Anyways, I'm going to get after this. If it rains, anything I might could harvest on the edge, you know, that'll turn into cement. So, hey. And I'm only going to do this for about an hour, so we'll call this a wrap for today's videoing. Hi, it's 8:45 a.m. I was done at 8 a.m. with the tools sprayed off and the wheelbarrow sprayed off and the buckets too that were left over from the other day. I was already hot and sweaty, the bandana was already soaked, and I done had enough talks with myself that all started with old woman, what are you doing? The clay that was wet inside the wheelbarrow pretty much started that conversation. It was sticking to the shovel very, very harshly. Hello, dog. And that got old. I threw a little bit more water in there to just be done with that part. I had the thought of, old woman, you're getting too old to be doing this. Well, I didn't like that either. Had another conversation with myself. Old woman, find another way. And so I did. From there to there is the first part of the clay that was just the initial wet. And then I threw on top of it some of the wetter when I was, you know, just about real through with it. Another way I found was to take a 5-gallon bucket, and I filled it about 3/4 full. Used a dolly to bring it back over here. I set it on its side and kind of rolled it to get some of the clay out of the bucket. Of course, I'd have to pick it up at the end, you know, tip it out to get the rest of it. I did that all the way around it. Here at the very end, when I was about to spray out the wheelbarrow, I didn't want to throw it away, so I took some of the wet mush and added it on top here. But here's more of the dry. I did a better job with the dry on this side. But if I decide it needs more clay, well, eventually I'll be getting more clay from here and these beds. And here you are, speaker. Been wondering where you went to. That's how my little Fiskars tool disappears and gets found. But anyways, I'm done for today. As much as I want to open up some of those bags of peat moss, I really am tempted. I want to say that I won't, but I don't know. The caulking has not cracked that's in the corners, so I don't need to do that again. As far as I'm concerned, it's ready for the peat moss and the soil. feel the edges are deep enough, I'm not going to worry about making a line of clay around the edges of the wood. As I'm looking at it, there's cracks in that wood there that could probably use some caulk. That's what I might do. And just let it sit today. Yeah, that would be advisable. I have the caulk, so why not? You see those cracks? I can't see the screen too good, so I'm hoping you can. But that would be a weakness for the nightmare grass to work its way through. Because it finds its way. So I've probably beat that horse dead, huh? Alright. Have a great day. Thanks for being here. Appreciate you. Bye-bye. No, little wasp. Do not build a home inside the wet clay. Really, do not build a home inside the wet clay. Please don't. Okay, bye-bye, y'all. Okay, it's midday, but the real feel is 94. 87 temp, 94 real feel. And I can't stand it. I want to see how full the beds become or how little full they become with the peat moss. But here we go. Oh, there will be at least three bags in there. All right, pause. Well, that's three bags of peat moss at 66 pounds per bag. 198 pounds of peat moss. And I'm thinking after I wet it down, the fourth bag will probably go in here too. But I'm going to wet it down first and make sure it shrinks and that doesn't poof up like core. Yeah. Anyway. Wish me luck, it doesn't poof up like corn. I'd estimated 10 bags to do these. So apparently I'm not far off. Okay, there we go. Let's wet it down really, really well. I'm gonna let it sit for a few hours and absorb the water. I noticed when I'd spray at the top and it would move a little bit, what was under it was still dry. So I think there's nothing for it right now but to walk away. Okay, I'll walk away and hope I don't come back to mushroom. I'm not being dramatic. I've only bought one bag of peat moss before, same size. And I made that bag stretch 2 years. Hell, I used the last of it in that bed right there. So, but it's like 1 o'clock in the afternoon. It's the cold front isn't here yet per se. But yet it is, because we have a breeze and we're not above 95 real feel yet. So, well, I'm hot and I'm sweaty. It's not dangerous hot. It is hotter than I like it to be. Okay, pause. I'll bring you back when I use a fork on it to see if it's, you know, all getting wet. Okay, pause. Well, I've been back inside for about 20 minutes and the sweat's still coming down. I mean, just, it's still coming down. It got hot out there. It got hotter than I realized. I'm glad I knew to come in even without realizing how hot it was feeling. It was 99 real feel when I came in. I was out there tops 25 minutes. Y'all be careful out there, okay? Around 6 o'clock tonight, it might drop to real feel of 90, and I might go back out there then. It's 1:45-ish now, but this video is pretty long. Perhaps I'll save that for tomorrow. Show you what happened. Yeah. Have a good night. Y'all be safe out there. Be aware of the heat. Stay alive, okay? Please. Alright. You're gonna be careful, right? Everybody's telling me to be careful. Y'all be careful too. Okay, bye-bye. Do-do-do-do-boop.